All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming out to Eddie's Attic tonight. Before we get the show kicked off, we'd like to remind you of just a few housekeeping rules that we have here at Eddie's Attic. First off, Eddie's is a smoke-free facility. That means we ask that if you would like to smoke, you should please exit this room, head down the stairs and outside of the building. Please remember that Eddie's is a listening room. That means be sure to silence your cell phones, try and keep conversation to a minimum, and most importantly, enjoy the music. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to the stage, Billy Stonecipher.
It's a wonderful day in the neighborhood. A wonderful day for a neighbor. Could you mind? It's a neighborly day in this beauty hood. A neighborly day for a beauty. Would you be mine? Would you be mine? I've always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you. So let's make the most of this beautiful show. While we're together, we might as well say, could you be mine? Would you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Won't you please? Won't you please? Please won't you be my neighbor?
Jordan Hamilton, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, goodness. Well, this is a dream come true. It's the most... It's the most people I've ever been in a dream with. I was thinking about that. The word dream just kept coming to mind. There's one thing I want you guys to walk away with tonight, if there's anything at all. And that's to not give up, whatever that looks like for you in your life, to not give up. That's what's been on my part. You can see it. There it is. So the first song I'd like to start with is not a song at all, which I know sounds strange because it kind of is. It's more of a meditation. It's my version of And what I mean by that is there's no real lyrics. There's only a couple. I can feel it and bring it back. And the reason I find that important is because something I've learned in life is that there's nothing more magical than the present moment. So if you join me in that space. I'd love to have you. I can feel it and it's pretty crazy. One day I'm dying one day life is amazing. Promise I wouldn't cry. I'm gonna try. Thank you for being here. Thank you for my whole life. Bring it back. That there's a light that shines, no matter the circumstance. There's a light that shines, and we let our souls dance. Bring it back, bring it back. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. That is the scariest song to play. I kind of regret making that decision years ago that this was a song I was going to do, but when anything is scary, it's typically a good thing to dive into. Anyways. I've thought for a long time about what type of experience I wanted this to be tonight, and it came to me that I wanted to tell you guys a story. And in that thought, I realized I wanted to tell you guys my story because it's the one I know the best, give or take. You know, some things are fuzzy. So be honest, a lot's fuzzy, huh? I have a lot of fun first memories. I remember getting this scar. You probably can't see it because of my hair. But I picked up a VHS off the shelf. It was the Batman and Robin movie with Mr. Freeze. Some say the worst Batman. I love it for sentimental reasons. I remember my parents getting into a fight. And in my young innocence, I turned to them and was confused and said, "Why are you guys fighting? Never seen them do that." I remember going to the Center of Puppetry for Arts with my mom. And this huge puppet came out of the woodworks. And I was really scared. I said, "Mom, Mom, it's a monster." And she said, "No, Billy, it's not real. There's nothing to be afraid of." And unfortunately, I remember the night my mom passed away. I was 6 years old when I found her cold on the floor, lying in my screaming father's arms. "This is how you make a man." Now I need love the most, chasing after a ghost. If I became a big star, would she find me then? Oh, I'm hurting. Oh, I'm hurting. Am I worth it? Never was the same. We will never be. I'm still bursting at the seams, but oh, she'd say a little water never hurt anyone. Oh, she'd say a little water never hurt anyone. Oh, she'd say a little water never hurt. She's not here, and it feels like I'm drowning. She's not here, and it feels like I'm drowning. She's not here, and it feels like I'm drowning. So one night, me and my dad got talking. And he said, "Billy, your mom was really good at not letting things get to her." And he told me this story about how their apartment flooded. And he was all panicked. You know, who are we going to hire to fix it? How much is it going to cost? Where are we going to stay? So that's clearly where I get my anxiety from. Thanks, Dad. And he said that she turned to him and said, "Marcus, a little water never hurt anyone. So if you do me the honor, I'd love if we could sing that together in honor of her, honor of everyone we've lost." It goes like this. Oh, she'd say a little water never hurt anyone. Oh, she'd say a little water never hurt anyone. Oh, she'd say a little water never hurt anyone. last time. Thank you all so much for that. It's undeniably hard to lose someone. But it's so amazing to me that they can live on in their lessons and memories. And I just thank you guys so much for that. That was, you never know what's gonna happen when you ask the crowd to sing. Thankfully, I got some vocal instructors in the house. Shout out to those two. More on that later. So it's obviously not an ideal way to start a life. I'm glad there's some dark humor fans out there. We are at home, okay. But it is a way to start a life. And something like that really shaped a lot of my behaviors, bad decision making.
Listen now, I plead my case. I'm not a beast, but I wrong with the human race.
When I was 16, I made a new friend, one of my best friends. Stuff that gets you high. Could be anything. Hey, yeah. Again, family.
Made my way down to the garden to pick myself a flower, maybe two. Slyly slipped right through the cracks to grab myself some sassafras and run back home to the blues. See, we all start tumbling down like a rock from a boulder, like one in the crowd. So scream your voice and scream it proud. Oh, I know that sound.
But things aren't always bad. Sometimes things go your way.
Hang on to your heads, we're coming home. Hang on to your heads, we're coming home. Like a freight train down the fast lane, we're coming all home. Like a freight train down the fast lane, we're coming home.
And then you meet a girl. Shout out my brother Charlie on this one. You realize there's something called mommy issues. Who would have known?
But lately, I don't know where you've been standing. Cause I've been standing right here all along. So why the hell are we waging war when you have all the soldiers? I've been waving my white flag so damn long. I've been waving my white flag so damn long. Why do you feel like
this was always bad for my health?
So
your life.
I'm losing something more than myself.
And after all those journeys, there's only one thing I really know. And I don't know where I'm heading next. All I know is that I'd expect it's probably not what I'm gonna get. Ain't life just the sweetest thing? Thank you. I want to say hello to the back section. I haven't really been able to look back that way. How are you guys doing back there? Heck yeah. It's a small room, but somehow you guys feel very far away. I don't know why. Well, that goes out to all my rookie year fans out there. The songs are old now. It happened like 5 years ago. But I realized it'd be such a shame if I didn't break some of those out for you guys who like them. So, after meeting that new friend that I really liked, I ended up meeting another new friend who I didn't really like at first, and that was rehab. But over time, you can't really shut the door on the past. When I first got there, a big part of their treatment plan was prayer. A little strange to me. Not to... Okay, maybe we don't all see eye to eye on everything. That's okay. Can't all go your way. But for any of you guys that are familiar with 12-step programs, prayer is pretty much step two. So they throw that one in there real quick. Step one is admitting you have a problem. And step two is God can save you. Which for me, it's like there's no way. No. God cannot save me. God has been an asshole to me up until this point. That is not going to work. But they said, look, I know it's crazy. A million of you guys come in here all the time and say the same thing. But just give it a try and see what happens. And I said, okay, that's fair enough. They said, you don't even have to pray to God. One of my favorite things they said, you can even pray to a doorknob. I heard Dort. Someone knows. Someone knows. God, I've prayed to a doorknob more times than I'd like to admit. But they were kind of right. They were kind of onto something. And it started out as I kind of did the prayers that my dad taught me when we were little. Say thank you for my family, thank you for my friends. Thank you for basketball. I hope nothing bad happens to anybody. So I kind of kept doing that, but it wasn't really working. And I learned a new prayer, which was, guess they call it God's Will's Prayer. I'm not really sure the proper term, but simply you'd say, Thy will be done. I like that one, because there's really no control in this life as much as I try and try and try and try and try and try. So when I got to Nashville, Tennessee, I went to a university there to study music. And when I first got there, there was this giant snowstorm, one of those snowstorms that shuts down the entire Southeast. You guys being here in Atlanta, I know you can relate to those. It's just an absolute nightmare. And I was scheduled to take a megabus, which is like a tier below Greyhound. I like it better, actually, but neither here nor there, so I digress. And I had no friends, really, because I just transferred to this college. My roommates weren't really willing to drive. My only friend was blind, so for obvious reasons. Some say Stevie Wonder can drive, but anyways. They weren't willing to drive, but my roommate told me, look, I think the bus stop is only 10 minutes away. You can make it. So I put it in my GPS, and it said 2.5 miles. The math didn't really add up, but I was in such a down place. I said, you know what? What do I have to lose? I'll go walk in the snow a little bit. It's better than sitting around with these guys who aren't willing to give me a lift. And I quickly find out the bus stop is not 10 minutes away. The GPS was right. The computer was right, which is bad news for all of us. But I decided, you know what, screw it, I'm going to try and make this bus. And for some reason, it came over to me, my rehab training kicked in. Let's say a prayer. Why not? And I did, and I, you know, kind of did the same silly stuff. But I said, you know, God, help me trust your will. I need some type of help here. And I kid you not, like magic, I became like a child. The snow looked fun. I was sliding. You know, there was no one on the streets. I was dancing around. I started jogging a little bit. And I saw, okay, I think I can actually make this bus time. 2.5 miles, whatever. I used to run cross country. Let's give it a go. It's coming down to the wire. And I notice my phone's going to die, which my, if anyone's, you know, traveled in the 21st century, your tickets are on your phone. And thinking, well, this is bad news. I'm going to get there and not know how to get back to my dorm. Holy shit, this is a mess. And so I start sprinting as carefully as you can in snow. Lo and behold, my phone dies right when I get to the bus man. And I say to him, look, I know this is a long shot. Is there any chance I can come onto the bus, charge my phone, and you can see my ticket? For those who've taken the Greyhound megabus, you guys know these drivers are not known for their accommodating spirits. I'm thinking there's no shot. He looks at me and goes, I get on that bus and plug in my phone. It was, still to this day, I can't believe it. I immediately started writing in my little journal. And from that came this song, Back on the Road. And I've only gotten to share that story at a couple of gigs before. And I like to think there's a lot of y'all out there probably who've heard it, then it realize every lyric is pretty much literal. I'm not that clever. Snow falls slow, paving the way. Forgot to say too, feel free to sing along at any point tonight if you like. Frozen road, tell me to stay. Yeah,
this sharpening cold cuts down to my bone. Brave in the wind, I walk through this storm. Oh, so back on the road, pick up my feet and go. Fixed on a star, I go with the hills and roll. The busman said I had to pay my toll. 'Cause it's a long way home. It's a long way home. But we must fight.
This part's a metaphor. So I can see. No walls. I was going through like Mario.
There's still life ahead of me. Inherently, I know. But my mind's been lost at sea. Now finally can be set free. Oh, so back on the road, I pick up my feet and go. Fixed on a star, I go with the hills and roll. Busman said I had to pay my toll. Says it's a long way home. It's a long way home. But we must fight. Oh, we must fight. Oh, we must fight. So back on the road, I pick up my feet and go. Fixed on a star, I go with the hills and roll. The busman said I had to plug in my iPhone. 'Cause it's a long way home. It's a long way home. We must fight. Oh.
Thank you so much. Told you singing's a sport. Maybe Courtney did. So in honor of rookie year, whoops. Made plenty of mistakes myself, actually. If you're curious to know, this heart was not supposed to be here. I made a boo-boo. And called some friends and said, we have a wardrobe emergency, which is the most metrosexual I've ever been. and he said, just put a heart on it. I said, that's a great idea. Anyways, in honor of rookie year, if you couldn't gather from that album title, I'm a huge sports fan. If I didn't have a rare bleeding disorder, I think I would have been a basketball player. But Taylor, would you cue some music for me? I want to do a fun little t-shirt cannon for you guys. Watch your drinks. No, I was thinking, why do athletes get to have all the fun? Why can't we do this at concerts? Watch your drinks.
The get-go, y'all hear my shit go, it's Andre. Can your punk ass come out to play safe? Stay in your little hole, then coward duck your head. You don't know who you be fucking with, you better off. Yeah, that's what I say, best run the other way. In case the physical breakdown, y'all can break now. My kitchen full of heat, if you can't take the tip, make yourself exempt. Pussy footing around, we getting y'all nowhere but stuck. Nowhere to duck, bullets fine. Niggas die, by getting blasted, how drastic.
Thank you, Taylor. It's gotta be Outkast, right? Ain't no thing but a chicken wing. I know some of you guys are thinking, gosh, this has been a very serious show so far. Which I am most of the time. I'm working on that. But I want to play something a little bit lighter. As I said before, I lived in Nashville for a while and really got inspired by country music. So this is a song called Cowgirl, and it goes out to all my single folks out there. Single? Okay, maybe we should talk after. Let me get a good look at it. No, just kidding. You're beautiful. I'm just a cowboy looking for my cowgirl. I haven't gotten very far. I don't got a fast horse. I'm just a cowboy looking for my cowgirl. But I don't think I'm ready to be going steady, baby. See, I'm just a man. I barely got a plan, and I'm getting by just fine. Okay, once I get my shit together, we'll be two birds of a feather, all right. I'm just a cowboy dreaming about my cowgirl. Oh, there's no need to rush. You'll be my cowgirl for life. That's the good news. No need to rush, I'll be your cowboy for life. Babe, in due time, we'll be kicking up sand side by side. There's no need to rush, we'll be kissing through the night. I wrote that one during mating season. The reason I fell in love with country music is because they made drinking sexy. You know, being drunk and being a fool, they made it sound really cool. That was not intended to be a lyric. So safe to say rehab did not completely work the first time around. This song is called Drunkard's Nursery Rhyme. All my friends are getting high.
somehow they're still getting by, hitting home runs. I'm getting picked off at first. The drinks are loosely flowing, my skin is barely glowing. I'm a zombie, but I'm harmless, oh, I swear. I just drink way too much too often until it becomes my oxygen. I don't fit in, I'm blowing bubbles like a fish. Hey, I can't get enough of this stuff. It's driving me crazy. Hey, I can't get enough of this stuff. It's driving me crazy. All my friends are getting high. Somehow they're still getting by. I got too drunk and forgot to show up to the game. Thank you. There comes a moment in life when you realize what you're doing just ain't working anymore. A good friend of mine, Luke Putney, once said, "Yesterday's medicine isn't always tomorrow's medicine." And man, that slapped me right across the face. I quit drinking 2 weeks later. But it's something I haven't really talked about much because it's a symptom of a deeper problem. So whatever it may be for you, like I said, my friend, stuff that gets you high, it can be anything. It feels so good to just do that stuff. I've been playing that 2K basketball game for like 30 years now. Way too much of that, right? I mean, it could be video games, it could be, insert the blank. Play the Mad Lib for yourself. And I wrote this song when I wanted to stop digging that hole. I was out with friends one weekend, drank a bunch, came home, and decided I wanted to make some nachos. So I put the nachos in the oven, I went to my couch, and I woke up to my roommate coming home going, "Oh my God, what's that smell?" And I woke up, "Oh shit, I cooked nachos for 6 hours. Great for barbecue, terrible for nachos. I was working for Santa that year, I was making coal." But I had some friends that that happened too. Friends who I thought, gosh, I'll never let it get that bad. Famous last words. This song's called Fairly Hell. Which I hope you can listen to and think to yourself, just take it as a little push to try and give up the type of stuff that you just don't want to be doing anymore. You know that's hurting you. It goes like this.
Fairly hell, my honey. Fare thee well, my soul. Fairly hell, my honey. Fare thee well, my soul. Oh, I've been dreaming of utopia. All I got left is fear.
My heart is heavy, my mind's a cloud. When will bad news appear? A big old tornado blew right through my front door. Now I'm trailing an uneven score. Oh, my heart's heavy, my mind is a cloud. When will bad news appear?
Fare thee hell, my honey. Fare thee well, my sweet.
My baby bottle don't taste good no more. My heart is heavy, my body's on the floor. Almost burnt the house down with me inside. Oh my God, won't you take me alive? Fare thee hell, my. Fare thee well, my soul. Fare thee hell, my. Fare thee well, my soul. Been down this trail, you could call me pioneer. Leaving my pieces behind. You'd think a sane man would try something else. Oh, the devil is so cavalier. Fare thee hell, my honey. Fare thee well, my soul. Fare thee hell, my honey.
I hear some folks singing along, and this is something I've wanted to try before, and since whoever's being a little bird over there, you sound wonderful, you've inspired me to try this. I want to try it. We do fare thee hell, our honey, fare thee well, our soul. If you join me with that. Feel free to dip your toe in.
Fare thee hell, our honey. Fare thee well, our soul. Fare thee hell, our honey. Fare thee well, our soul.
Just one more time. Y'all sound amazing. Thank you. Gosh, that was awesome. So we are recording this, and my lawyer told me to mention, you know, we are going to monetize this. And in when you bought your tickets, you did sign off that you were not going to be receiving any royalties for your performance. And thank God, because you guys sound so good. You could have negotiated the crap out of that. No, seriously, amazing. So, this is insane to me. We sold this show out. I didn't realize I knew that many people. I was not expecting it at all, not being humble. I mean, last show I played, I think, I won't say. So I want to do something kind of interesting here. This is like our seventh inning stretch. There are some folks here, I have no idea who you are, and I want to do a little seventh inning stretch interview with you.
Check one. Check two. Taylor, get this, mobile mic going. It's quiet enough.
Oh, there we go. Okay. Let's see. I want to find someone I don't know. Okay, I know everyone in the front row, of course. You, ma'am, we've never met before. What is your name?
Leanna.
Billy, pleasure to meet you. So, what brought you here tonight?
I went to college with Bobby.
You went to college with Bobby, okay, my brother. Well, that makes sense. That makes me not look as cool, but thank you so much for your time. Let's see, do you know any of my family members? Okay, so same problem. Oh, the Maldens. Hello. How are you guys? Good to see you. You're related? You're my number one fan? What? Gosh, you grew up so fast. This is your daughter? Oh, my goodness. Well, 16. Yeah. Cowgirl was not for her. That's right. We do not condone this. Remind me your name.
I'm Natalie.
Natalie, that's right. Okay, well, have you been enjoying the show?
Yes, I love it.
You love it. Did you have a favorite song so far?
Well, I want to hear more off Rookie Year.
You want to hear more off Rookie Year? Okay. Well, that's, I don't know if we have that in the itinerary, but... We didn't, should I say that again?
You should put it in.
Put it in, okay.
Do Sun and the Stars.
Sun and the Stars, okay. We might have to, let's see. I think we can sneak that in for you. I think we can do that. Is there anything you would change about the show? New game plan, you know, take someone out, put someone in?
Me, obviously.
You? You want to get on stage?
I mean.
A little bit? You might sing something with me? You're down? Okay, well then, we're going to do Sun. You want to do Sun in the Stars right now? Come on. I promise this was not planned at all, which is very fun. I'll give you this mic. To find my lyrics online. You're not going to find those.
Oh, shit.
We've reached a milestone. My lyrics are online.
This is like our timeout. Can't get in our huddle.
Oh my God, oh please refrain, 'cause I'm already in the falling rain. Why won't you touch
me now? I can see your smile in your
eyes.
Stars that shine twice as far from me, I know. Me, I know.
Natalie Malden, ladies and gentlemen. They took our jabs. They took our jabs. That was amazing. Oh my gosh.
Well, I'm glad we did that post-game interview. That's not where I expect that to go at all. It was beautiful. I think you missed the piece where she's 16. Not gonna work. What's the deal? Divide by two, add seven, right? Something like that. So 15, 22, yeah, we missed our window. Well, this night is taking a turn. Call my lawyer. We foresaw the royalties. We did not foresee the worst mess ever. Oh, goodness, I am so off the rails. How do we bring this story back? This next song I'm gonna play, it's funny that they took our jobs came up. It has actually a little bit of South Park influence here. This song's called La-Di-Da. And a friend of mine's in the house. I wasn't expecting her to be here, but her name is Sephora. I think she's in the back. She's one of my neighbors, and she told me one day we were having a philosophical talk, as we like to do. And she told me something. She goes, you know, nothing changes if nothing changes. Brilliant. Never heard it put that way before. And basically, I have a problem with problems. When things get bad, I let them stay bad. Something I've learned is that action is the antidote most of the time. Just doing something about it, anything at all. And to tie in the South Park reference, the pre-chorus goes, la-di-da-dum-dum, la-di-da-dum-dum-dum, la-di-da-dum-dum, la-di-da-dum-dum-dum. So for all you South Park fans out there, there was an episode they did about Mormonism. And that was Adam Smith's theme song. He'd walk around, they'd go, dum-da-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum. Which I have no opinion on Mormonism. But I do have opinions about my own life. And I know the answer. You gotta do something about it. I slept for 24 hours trying to escape it. I've once been brave, but today I just won't make it.
take me to my grave. There I'll lie complacent. We'll be singing la di da dum dum, la di da dum dum dum, la di da dum dum, la di da dum dum dum, la di da dum dum, la di da dum dum dum, la di da dum dum, la di da dum dum dum.
You hold through the wall, but I know I ain't that tough. So I'll lose my mind. So I'll lose my mind. I can punch your hole through the wall, but I know I ain't that tough. So I'll lose my mind. So I'll lose my mind.
I've been trying to wake up, but my couch just feels so damn good. My friends have been a-calling, but they don't know I'm up to no good.
Shout out to my friends, they started to figure it out.
I'm circling down the train, but it still won't wash my pain away.
We'll be singing la di da dum dum, la di da dum dum dum, la di da dum dum, la di da dum dum dum, la di da dum dum, la di da dum dum dum. La di da dum dum, la di da, la di da.
I can punch a hole through the wall, but I know I ain't that tight. So I'll lose my mind. So I'll lose my mind. I can punch a hole through the wall, but I know I ain't that tight. So I'll lose my mind. So I'll lose my mind. I'm the center of my universe. This is my movie. We're at the bad part. Nothing is groovy. I lost my mind, lost my house, lost everything but myself. No wonder I'm so goddamn lonely.
Thank you. So as a musician, a lot of times we get the question, so tell me about yourself. You know, what type of music do you make? What's it about? That's a loaded question, right? I've tried to come up with little clever taglines and stuff before, but it always just feels a little too corporate. But simply, I want to make music to help you out, to make your life a little better. Kind of like one of my corny little tags is self-help books, but in music form. So many times I want to turn to a song, and I don't really have one to go listen to. I don't really like listening to myself. It's a little, well, I think we can all fill in that word. Or maybe not, just self-indulgent. This is Brighter Day.
It's a brighter day in a brighter way. I can sleep at night now you're not with me. I don't see your shade. I let it dissipate. Cause you are of my own making. It's just you and me trying to be. And I know that you want to be free. I choose to believe we are loving beings. What other choice do we have to choose? It's a brighter day in a brighter way. I can sleep at night now that you're not with me. I don't see your shame. I let it dissipate. Cause you are of my own making. I don't see no hate. I let it walk on its way. With a smile on my face. Oh, I found love in the pain. You can call me a hippie or really strong,
but all I'm saying is all that I know.
So we gonna hold on, love. We gonna hold on, love. We gonna hold on, love. We gonna hold, we gonna hold. It's a brighter day in a brighter way. I can sleep at night now that you're not with me. I don't see your shade. I let it dissipate. Cause you are of my own making.
I got sick of playing singer-songwriter music all the time and wanted something we could all dance to a little bit.
It's a brighter day.
Feel free to get out of your seats if you're feeling brave. Or let me look goofy.
We gon' fight for love while everybody else is fighting. We gon' fight for love while everybody else is fighting. We gon' fight for love while everyone really fighting about nothing. We gon' fight for love while everybody else is fighting. It's a brighter day in a brighter way. I can sleep at night now that you're not with me. I don't see your shade. I let it dissipate. Cause you are of my making. We gon' hold on, love. We gonna hold on, love. We gonna hold on, love. We gonna hold, we gonna hold.
Thank you so much. Was someone gonna tell me this happened? How long has this been off my jacket? How embarrassing. No one, it's like, is it, I got some in my teeth too?
It was supposed to happen. Well said. We're going to put it. Oh gosh, is this going to work? They shut for some reason.
It's a false pocket.
What a lie. I know this is riveting entertainment. It's what you paid the big bucks for.
Whose idea was that? Who said put it in the pocket? My new marketing manager right here, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Well, y'all, we just have a couple songs left. Get home in time for bedtime. So I've really struggled with sharing this or not tonight. But sometimes I know something just has to be done. If you remember at the start of the show, so long ago now, I said if there's something I want you to take away from tonight is to not give up. And the reason that's been so prevalent in my life, there's no pretty way to say this. I have attempted suicide twice since 2021. And I haven't told anyone that before because, well, it's not a fun discussion. You might be thinking, what a frickin' insano to say that on stage to a bunch of people, but for some reason, that's the only place it feels right to say. And if that had worked, which is a funny way to put that, right? I wouldn't have been able to have this experience tonight, which is simply the biggest milestone of my career. To imagine what that might look like in your life if you're struggling in any way like I am. The best thing may be ahead of you. Probably is. So I wrote this song. This is called Outlaw. Wish I were an outlaw, living life on the edge, with a sense of adventure. I ain't right in the head. Guns would be smoking. My heart still be broken. Living over and over and over and over and over and over again. Dry as a desert. And alone as the moon. Without no stars to say goodnight to. Oh, there's never a good time to take your life. Oh, there's never a good time to take your life. I'd kill to be happy with tears in my eyes. No more me, my soul would leave its body in its place. So I run to the hills to no longer be a man, to be taken by the bottle, the revolver, the land.
Oh, there's never a good time to take your life. Oh, there's never a good time to take your life. See, that was a funny saying we had in rehab. We had a lot of funny ones. We'd say, you can kill yourself, you're welcome to do it, but there's never a good time to do it. That's the kind of dark humor we use to cope with that insane situation, right? We'd say, you could kill yourself, but you just wrote that essay, like, don't you, that was a lot of work for nothing. You could kill yourself, but you just started dating that girl, and that could go well. There's always that appointment you already put the deposit on, and you got your grandma's birthday party next week. You obviously can't do that to grandma. Not to mention you and your dad are finally getting along. And you're finally, finally starting to sing your songs. I don't want to be the one who decides. I don't want to be the one who decides. I don't want to be. Thank you so much. Thank y'all so much. Y'all really didn't have to do that. Thank you. Well, I have one last song to leave us with. Might be crazy. Now I feel like that should have been the closer, huh? But you can't end with pain. Oops. The Lord works in mysterious ways. This is called shape-shifting. It's all because a different kind of love, neither here nor there, but very near. I've been stretched out far to every corner, take a left. Life's a circle.
And I can't see it, so I go on believing. Pain is the deepest feeling. I know it's so, 'cause I've been healing. And I can't hold it, so I go on believing. Hiding under the shallow sea. Love is always gonna be shifting.
I got my backpack on. And my boots tied tight. Always been an explorer, even through the horror. My blessing, my curse, my better, my worse. That's the trick. I was taught by magic.
I know it's so, 'cause I've been healing, and I can't hold it, so I go on believing, hiding under the shallow ceilings.
Love is always gonna be shifting. Thank y'all very much. Oh, holy shit. Thank y'all. Thank you. Thank y'all so much.
This has been a dream, man. That's all my time. You guys get home safe. I'll see you again.